gospel reading this morning is from the book of Matthew, chapter 13, verses 1 through 9. That same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat beside the sea. Such great crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat there while the whole crowd stood on the beach. And he told them many things in parables, saying, "Listen, a sower went out to sow. And as he sowed, some seeds fell on the path, and the birds came and ate them up. Other seeds fell on rocky ground, where they did not have much soil, and they sprang up quickly, since they had no depth of soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched, and since they had no root, they withered away. Other seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. Other seeds fell on good soil and brought forth grain, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. Let anyone with ears listen." The word of God for the people of God. Friends, I come before you today to confess that I have fallen down the rabbit hole, otherwise known as Ancestry.com. It started out gradually. I would watch those genealogy shows on TV, finding your roots and who do you think you are, and I would be fascinated with the revelations that celebrities like Oprah and Stephen Colbert would discover about their ancestors, the people, the places, and the stories that had helped shape who they are today. And I thought, why not me? And if you think this sounds interesting, and in my opinion it is, I do recommend that you just go ahead now and kiss whatever free time you have goodbye. I also recommend that you consider taking the genealogy class offered through the UT non-credit outreach program before you get too far into it. Otherwise, you will probably find out that much of what you have done is already wrong. But I digress. I will say that my own journey into my ancestry has been as enlightening, for me at least, as for any of the celebrities that I have seen on the genealogy shows. Some of the things that I have learned so far have reaffirmed what I had already been told by living relatives. But there have also been a few surprises along the way. For example, I had been told that my ancestry is German, among other things. But what I have discovered is how very, 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 very German I am. In fact, on my dad's side of the family, other than the great-grandfather who came from Devon, England, and gave us all the name Avery, pretty much everyone else on that branch of the family goes back to Germany within a few generations. I have also learned that my mom's side of the family is a little more varied in background, although there are a good number of Germans there too, along with some French and Scotch-Irish. On the other hand, no one had ever mentioned to me any Dutch heritage, but I discovered a 9th great-grandmother who came from Holland. She seems to have arrived in New York, or New Amsterdam, as it was known then, in the 1600s, which was another revelation for me. Because I had thought that my ancestors were all more recent immigrants to this country, arriving from Europe in the 1800s. And this is actually the case for most of them, but I have been surprised to discover that a few of the branches on my family tree, like that one, do seem to go back much, much further. However, even that has not been the most surprising revelation for me. Having been born and having lived out my childhood in Michigan, the child of grandparents and grandparents, also born in Michigan, I have always known myself to be a transplanted northerner during the time I have lived in Tennessee. I drink my tea unsweet, and I had never even heard of a pimento cheese sandwich, much less tasted one, before I came to Knoxville. So you can imagine my shock when I found out that my third great-grandfather, James A. Jones, was born about 1812 in Frederick County, Virginia. From this distance, we can only speculate what his motivation might have been. Maybe the specter of slavery and the gathering storm leading up to the Civil War were factors, or maybe not. Maybe Michigan, which had only recently attained statehood, simply offered greater economic opportunity. But the records show that sometime in the 1830s, James and his wife, Eliza, moved their young family from Frederick County, Virginia, to Berrien County, Michigan.